Welcome to CSL TV, and I just hope you're having a beautiful, blessed day. Now, if you're new to the channel, subscribe. You'll be helping me out. It's free. You're doing a good deed, and it's just a review, a reaction, as well as an informational channel. Also, I just want to say shout out to Stay Tuned, Maya, and the whole team over there. We having tremendous work that they be showing. You know what I'm saying? We be getting this content from. But as in like most of the news is always gonna be, you know what I'm saying, bad with some good in it. So just hope you guys having a blessed day. I don't want to bore y'all too much. Let's get it.
People are calling him the pervy police chief because he shared intimate videos of Megan Hall and made nasty comments about her on a secret prepaid phone he called the old boy. She's got a tight little though.
That's what people think of me. I don't want to work in an environment like this.
When the chief found out that Megan had slept with half a dozen of his police officers, he was first mad and yelled at her for dipping her pen in company ink.
You talked about his size, what it looked like.
I just gave him in the substation.
But then he felt jealous and wanted to be part of the party. That's why he allegedly started harassing her and asked one of his trusted officers to send him explicit videos of her. When the investigation began, the chief's phone was taken, and you won't believe what the investigators found in it.
How could I get justice when the entire system, including the chief, not only condoned such behavior, but participated in it?
When the Cop Gone Wild scandal came to light, the police chief Burrell Chip Davis, who is married and a father of three, pretended to be surprised and said he knew nothing about it. In reality, he knew everything. He knew that the 26-year-old cop had an innocent baby face, had been having fun with six police officers, at crazy hot tub parties, while playing strip Uno, and even at her workplace. But instead of stopping it or making something about it, the chief tried to be part of the party. He often invited her to lunch, he asked her to dance with him in his office, and he even questioned her if she liked dark, light, or chocolate milk. The messages found in the chief's prepaid phone show that he complained about his own failed attempts to bed Officer Hall. It was also found that the chief convinced Sergeant McGowan to send him an intimate video of Megan where she is touching herself. But when the investigators asked the chief about it, he said he had deleted all the data. Little did he know that Officer McGowan had not deleted anything. Eventually, the explicit photos, messages, and videos ended up in the hands of the investigators, and now they are being used as evidence in the lawsuit filed by Megan against the former police chief. But Megan is not only suing the chief, she is also suing Sergeant Henry McGowan because he allegedly promised to help her get a promotion in exchange for sex.
She was looked at as a piece of meat.
She is also accusing McGowan for smacking her, harassing her for sex, and offering to create adult content videos. Sergeant Powell is also being sued because he allegedly threatened to kill himself if she stopped the relationship. This allegedly caused Megan anxiety, depression, and at one point she even tried to take her own life.
I received harassing and threatening messages on my phone daily.
Despite Megan's claims, many people believe she did all this because she wanted to. That's why she never complained to anyone. This may be true, since the person who reported what was happening was not her, but one of the police officers she was sleeping with.
So you mean to tell me the police chief start harassing her, so he can get sexual favors, you know what I'm saying, and all this other shit? I bet when he first started this, she was probably weirded out. What the fuck you all to me for? And then, you know what I'm saying? He like, oh, I know what you're doing with the guys. What's up with me though? Got a whole family and kids. And you up here harassing her for sexual favors. That's just crazy. And then, one of the guys had the nerve to send him this shit. You know what I'm saying? Against what she wanted. And yeah, what if she did want to get ran by all those dudes? Because her little cheating ass too. But that's her business. That's their business. They wasn't harassing her. Well, the guy who was trying to say he'll kill himself. But he a simp anyway.
Give me some space, dude.
Go in, turn.
Give me some space, dude.
Put your hand behind
your back. No, give me some... Help! Oh!
Behind your
For
back.
For what? For what?
Put your piece.
For,
not for you?
Yo, get away from me, buddy.
No, no, dude. Who are you?
Away from me, dude.
Why are you here?
Back the
Why are you here?
I suggest you leave me alone.
You're on private property.
I suggest you do something about that then and get back inside.
Ooh.
Really?
Yeah, really. You like going around people like this?
You know what?
You think that's fun? Don't
touch my buddy.
Do it.
What?
Touch it. That's on camera.
What are
back
we doing? What are we doing here?
Back the off, buddy. You touch, you get tased. Get the back inside.
What's going on here?
Why do you come up and grab me?
You back off.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did, buddy.
Get that thing out of my face.
No, you f***ing come up to me, get in my face, right, I'll do something,
call,
buddy.
Call,
get inside.
I'll call 911.
Get inside.
Call the sheriff's department. Yep. Whoa, dude,
you just come up and grab people? The f*** is wrong with you? Your homie did.
Don't hate my homie. This is private property. You say you're filming.
This is an easement. I'm not on your property. You see that? That belongs to the city.
And why are you here?
Mr. Roberts tells the workers that he's on an easement and not on private property because the utility poles on the property belong to the city.
Hey,
you assaulted me, buddy.
Call 911.
Call the sheriff's department.
Hey, call your husband.
Yeah, call your husband. Fat boy.
Man, whoa, this guy's great.
Get in, Tubby. I'm out in public recording, and you come up and grab somebody, dude.
Who are you with?
I'm with myself.
Oh, you just
and you're about to owe me a new camera lens. Yeah, buddy, I got your name too. You're gonna get a nice little talking to with the police.
What's going on, bud?
Oh, nothing. Just getting assaulted out here. That's about it.
Getting assaulted?
Yeah, by one of their workers.
What happened?
I was just out here taking some pictures, and one of the guys came out here saying he didn't want to be filmed, and he ran up to me, started circling me. Grabbed my camera, started pushing up on me, and it's all videotaped.
You have it on video?
Oh, it's all recorded. Because I do want to press charges on him.
Was there something involving a taser?
Oh, I pulled it out in self-defense.
Okay.
When you come out at me like that and you're about to destroy my stuff and do bodily harm to me, you're damn right I'm going to pull a taser on someone.
Mr. Roberts argues that one of the workers assaulted him by grabbing his camera and pushing him, and that he pulled out his taser in self-defense in order to protect himself and his property. Here, it could certainly be argued that the worker had the required mental state in grabbing Mr. Roberts' camera to justify a conviction under Section 16-11-510, although it's unclear from the footage whether the camera was actually damaged, and it clearly was not destroyed, as Mr. Roberts was able to continue to film the encounter.
You need to tell that guy he needs not put hands on people. It's a short little fat guy.
I'm aggressive.
Okay. Oh yeah, we're gonna do a report on him too.
That's fine. I just need to give this deputy your information for me, alright? You have an ID or something?
I don't have an ID. Okay. Yeah, buddy, you're gonna learn you can't come outside and grab people, man. That ain't right.
Let me address something real quick. While we're handling this, don't yell. You're just
all right.
Calls him to get up.
Is it free speech? Am I allowed to say stuff?
Well, you have a freedom of speech, but there's also something called breach of peace.
Okay, I'd like to see you try that, buddy. Those people put hands on me. I'm the victim. So you want to turn it around on me?
I'm not turning it around.
Please do so.
What I'm telling you is...
You guys are known to be the biggest pieces of in South Carolina. Right. What did I do wrong?
Are you going to let me talk?
Go on ahead.
What I was saying is, I don't need you yelling while I'm trying to talk to this man, because that's going to cause him to yell. Calls a scene, you get mad, he's gonna get mad, then it escalates.
Okay.
Just talk to this deputy.
Let me tell you something, I'm allowed to say whatever the hell I want.
If you yell across this parking lot while you have all these people standing around, that is called breach of peace.
You want to try that, buddy?
I will lock you up.
You want to try that?
Yes, I will.
Two deputies with the Florence County Sheriff's Office responded to the worker's call. And while they're investigating the incident, one of them claims that if Mr. Roberts yells at the workers across the parking lot, he will be arrested for breach of peace. In South Carolina, breach of the peace is a common law crime, which means that it is defended by case law and not a statute. Mr. Roberts did use profanity during his interaction with the workers and the deputies. He did not use any profanity when he shouted across the parking lot, and even if he had, it is highly unlikely that a court would conclude that Mr. Roberts' suggestion that the workers were going to learn that they can't lay hands on other individuals would incite an average person to violence. Therefore, a court would most likely determine that Mr. Roberts' conduct did not constitute a breach of the peace or disorderly conduct, as he was engaging in speech that was protected by the First Amendment.
Not doing that.
Try it. Try it. Name and badge number.
Corporal Driggers, 1-8.
Name and badge number.
Driggers, 236.
All right, go do my assault charge.
I need you to give him your
You need to go talk to them. And you better file charges if I'm giving you my information.
What's your date of birth?
If you don't, believe me, you guys will get complaints, and this will
That's
be all fine. Over you.
Whatever you need to do, man.
They have to run me first, everyone. They can't run the actual criminal. Can you go tell them, go question the guy who assaulted me?
He's going to conduct his investigation. Do you see him up there?
No, he's not. He's inside hiding.
What was he wearing?
Yeah, a blue shirt. Short, dark hair, fat. So what was the call about?
Somebody coming up here harassing employees and pulling a taser on someone.
They tell you they circled me and surrounded me. The part where they assaulted me, they forgot, they let that out.
Hi, Mr. Roberts. I spoke with the two gentlemen that came out, and all their information is going to be entered into the report as well as your statement that you gave this deputy. I made them aware that yes, you can view video from a public area, which the roadway is public. But if you cross over into the
I've checked the property lines. I don't need directives.
You go on the property, you're going to go to jail.
If you smoke crack, that's not good, man. All right, do I get a report or something?
You got to get you a car.
Oh, great, this guy.
Here you go, buddy. All right, my name, badge number beside it, and your case number as well. You can get a copy of the report in 35 minutes. Have a good day.
Thank you. See how the cop tried to spin it and say I was in their parking lot?
How you doing, sir? How you doing, sir?
Not too good.
Wow, what's going on today, buddy?
I had some dude inside. Oh, you're getting really close, man.
Oh, yeah. I like to get close. I like to talk to people.
Can you stop?
No, sir.
So
I want to talk to you. What's
dude,
going on,
stop,
my friend?
Stop getting so close to me, dude.
What's going on, man?
Dude, stop approaching me.
Sir, I'm allowed
to off, dude. Okay. Give me some space, dude.
Go ahead and turn.
Give me some space,
put your
dude.
Hands behind your back.
No, give me some. Ow! Oh!
Behind your back.
For what? For what?
Put your piece.
For you?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Very nice, dude. Very nice. Enjoy the lawsuit. Enjoy paying for my camera, too.
Absolutely. You getting resisting arrest?
Resisting. I'm not moving.
Nope. When I went to put my hands on you, you pulled away from me.
Yeah, because you have no right to arrest me.
Sir,
I
you're
nothing.
Under arrest. You had the right to attorney
you
have him arrest.
You kept approaching me.
You sir, you had the right to attorney have him or present before any questions asked. You decide any time to exercise these rights and not make any more statements. Do you understand these rights?
I don't answer any more questions without a lawyer present.
Absolutely. All right, go and stand him up.
Sergeant Paul Morrison responds to the scene and approaches Mr. Roberts, who asks him several times to not stand so close to him and tries to step away. When Mr. Roberts directs a profanity at him, Sergeant Morrison tackles Mr. Roberts to the ground and tells him he's under arrest for resisting because he pulled away from him. And Mr. Roberts argues that he did so because Sergeant Morrison had no right to arrest him. It is important to keep in mind that this case law is specific to South Carolina, and many states do not recognize a citizen's right to resist an unlawful arrest. However, in this situation, Mr. Roberts would have a right to resist an unlawful arrest, and because he did not use any physical force at all by stepping away from Sergeant Morrison, there would be no question of disproportionate resistance if a court concluded that Mr. Roberts was resisting an unlawful arrest.
Enjoy getting to see you guys.
Absolutely. Got a taser, so...
Oh, yeah, I got assaulted.
So here's the thing, you pulled it out and you was threatening him.
He attacked me. It's on camera.
All right. Well, we're going to log all this in, too.
Right. Good. Do it.
After Sergeant Morrison placed Mr. Roberts under arrest, he was taken to jail and booked. However, it does not appear that any criminal charges were filed against Mr. Roberts, and after he was released, he filed a formal complaint with the Florence County Sheriff's Office. As a result of the complaint, the department opened an internal affairs investigation, and internal records indicate that Sergeant Morrison resigned on September 15, 2022. Sheriff T.J. Joy issued a press release about the incident, stating that, quote, "The internal affairs investigation determined numerous FCSO policy violations during the incident. As a result of the investigation, Sergeant Morrison is no longer employed by the Florence County Sheriff's Office." Sheriff Joy also noted that, quote, "The matter has been referred to the 12th Circuit Solicitor's Office, but as of the date of this episode, no criminal charges have been initiated against Sergeant Morrison." Posted to YouTube, along with a short video that appears to have been shot in the police cruiser after his arrest, which Mr. Roberts alleged Sergeant Morrison took while deleting the videos. Overall, Sergeant Morrison gets an F for unlawfully arresting Mr. Roberts without probable cause, using unnecessary force in conducting the illegal arrest, and attempting to cover his tracks by deleting Mr. Roberts' video footage of the encounter. While Sergeant Morrison claimed that he was arresting Mr. Roberts for resisting arrest, he had no legitimate reason to arrest Mr. Roberts in the first place, and it seems clear that he actually arrested Mr. Roberts for refusing to submit to his arbitrary displays of overreaching authority. This type of police behavior is not only completely unacceptable, but it's also dangerous dangerous. And I commend the Florence County Sheriff's Office for swiftly investigating and dealing with this situation. Although I do question the department's decision to allow Sergeant Morrison to resign rather than terminate him. The other Florence County deputies get a C, because although one threatened to arrest Mr. Roberts for breach of the peace in a situation that likely would not support such a conviction, they ultimately affirmed Mr. Roberts' right to film in public and educated the workers about his First Amendment rights. Although they appeared annoyed with Mr. Roberts and occasionally responded unprofessionally to his antagonistic remarks, they ultimately reached the right conclusion and supported his right to film. Mr. Roberts gets a B+, because although his aggressive and antagonistic behavior towards the workers and the officers alike certainly did not help the situation, and he demonstrated a misunderstanding about the nature of utility easements, he was well within his First Amendment rights throughout the encounter, and repeatedly stood up to the officers attempting to violate his First and Fourth Amendment rights. That being said, his mean-spirited comments about the workers' appearance were immature, and in my opinion, detracted from his credibility as a professional and respectable auditor.